and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to take a look at attributes. So, window, attributes, the attributes panel. And you might have used that before because you needed overprint fill or overpin stroke. And maybe you have even taken a look at the menu of this panel and selected show all and seen all these buttons. So, what do these buttons do? In order to check this out, we are going to first take a look at brushes. I've got here the Elegant Curl and Floral brush set, which is a default brush set in Illustrator. And when you use that, I'm going to take the brush tool and then select one of these brushes. And you see, you can draw a nice line with that. This is cool. But let's delete that, because when you draw a line that intersects itself, then you get this hole in here. And it's really a hole. It's not just white. It's punched out. This also happens with another one of these brushes, this one. When you zoom in, you see there's the hole. So maybe you also tried out something else. Let's delete this one and take the pencil tool and let's draw a shape that intersects itself, like so. And when you fill that, you also get a hole. Now this is related. And in here, you also see what is set up in here. These buttons, when you hover over them, you see they are the fill rules. So this is even odd, and this is non-zero winding rule. That hole is actually desirable in some cases. When you have this situation and you want to get a ring or donut shape, then you select these two and go to Object, Compound Path, Make, and then you get a hole. So you see the shape below can be seen through it. So this is clearly a situation where this hole is desirable, but in this case, maybe not. So how do we get the way we want it? Now, in this case as well, Illustrator has applied the even odd winding rule. This is not the default. The default is non-zero. Non-zero is desirable for this situation and also for the brushes. But let's first take a look at what these even do. In the case of this shape, I had two shapes stacked on each other. And there we have even odd, and even odd just counts how many shapes there are stacked on each other. And in here we have two shapes, which is an even number, so even gets punched out, as easy as it is. So the moment I have three of them and then make the compound path, you see, there we have three ones stacked, which is an odd number, then we don't get a hole. And there as well, is just one odd number, no hole. Then we have the solution to this case. In here we have none, and here we have two. So, of course, we get a hole. Now, what if we apply the other one? There you see, no hole. But how does this work? Non-zero works differently because non-zero takes into account the direction of the path. Let's make it. I'm going to make a compound path again with these two, but what we're going to do is apply an arrowhead. So like this, we've got arrowheads applied now, which doesn't make any sense with a closed path, because usually you don't need an arrowhead with a closed path. But in this case, it will show us the direction of the path. So they both run into the same direction. Now I'm going to select them both and go to Object, Compound Path, Make. And you see, Illustrator made the compound path. This time it applied non-zero because I had selected it for previous shapes and now it got the default again. And what Illustrator did in order to create this is it had to correct the path direction. Because if we change the path direction, we will no longer get a hole. So we can do that actually. When you go to the direct selection tool and select just this path, then you can also select one of these buttons. And with these, you can change the path direction. So let's do that. You see, it runs in that direction again, in its original direction, and now we don't have a hole. So what the non-zero winding rule does is it applies a number to the direction of the path. So one of them is -1 and one of them is +1. And then it adds up all the numbers it applied to the paths in a certain location. And if the location is non-zero, then you don't get a hole. So that's how that winding rule works. Now, how does that work with the brush? The brush shapes themselves can have a winding rule attached. And when you drag them out of the brushes panel, like so, then you can select this path. And you see it has the rule attached. It has evenOdd attached. And evenOdd creates these holes at the intersections, as we have just seen. So what you need to do is set this to non-zero winding and then create the brush again. So let's take this back into the panel and I'm going to press the Alt key to replace the existing brush, like so. And then let's try this out. So I'm going to the brush tool and you see, this time it doesn't create this hole. So this is how the winding rules in the attributes work and what they can do for you to solve your issues. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.